Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this tiny box. This is part of the TP-Link Omada range, probably one of the key components of the TP-Link Omada range. This is the OC200. This is the entry-level on-premise controller for the whole Omada range. Not going to be a big technical overview. We've got another video on what do I need to run TP-Link Omada. But this is the key, one of the key components. You do need a controller, something that can manage the access points and the switches and the routers that you've got on the network. And you've got the OC200 and the OC300. The OC300 can handle more, but for most people, this is probably a great starting point. So let me show you what you're going to get in the box. You're going to probably get about a meter and a half Cat5 cable, maybe Cat6 cable. You're going to get four little feet, all right, that you can stick on the bottom of your device because it is tiny and it can be mounted on a rack or your desk. You're going to get your little normal licensing document. You're going to get your little warranty document. You are going to get your installation guide. It's just going to show you how to get that all wired together. And you're going to get a little booklet on all the other Omada products because Omada is part of an ecosystem that's got routers, switches, wireless access points, controllers, and slowly some of the other TP-Link products are being moved into the same interface as well. But you're saying, Paul, I want to see the actual device. Well, let me show you. This is it. So let me draw this up for you. You will notice to start with that we had no power pack and no PoE injector in the box. This is powered by PoE, 802.3AF, so it only needs a few watts of power. Or it can be powered by, I think it's micro USB. So you'd need to have a power pack that does micro USB. So let me just show you what we've got. We've got some indicator lights on here to start us. We have our PoE in Ethernet port, and we have a second Ethernet port here for the LAN, I think. Then we've got a USB, which I believe you can do some backup options on. And we've got our small reset hole there. This is metal construction. There are no fans inside it. It's side vented. Here's our micro USB in, and I think our Kingston lock option over here. This is not a router. This is just a controller. This is where you're going to adopt all the access points. You're going to set up all of your management. You do all your VLANs. It doesn't do VLANs and routing. It does the management of the VLANs and routing. So as you add your other things like switches or routers or access points, this is what they communicate with and pick up the config and how they upgrade themselves as well. So this is an integral part of TP-Link Omada and what you need to actually run the system. So this is your good entry level. I can't remember the total specs, but this is probably going to be good for 40 or 50 devices quite comfortably on your network. Remember, you're going to need to PoE power this to make this work. And once this is set up on your network, you can add all of your other TP-Link Omada devices. Hopefully that's been helpful just to show you what was in the box. Not a lot. Sometimes we don't see these things. Oh, just on the bottom here, we do have our holes there to be able to mount that on a wall if we wanted to. But it should just give you a little bit more of an idea of how big it is and what's actually with it in the box. Head on over to our YouTube channel. Got plenty more box openings on wireless network firewall devices. We've got a video on there. What do I need to run TP-Link Omada? So if you're not sure, why don't you subscribe and stay up to date.